Let's say you got this wonderful idea of creating a token or coin and then launching it through decentralized exchanges. Well, the question might be how to do that. How exactly do you raise funds for your projects? Today we are going to talk about exactly that. IDOs, ICOs and IEOs. Hi, my name is Vlad and this is your Bunny Money channel with a weekly dose of finance and crypto related info. Before we dive in into today's subject, I would like to remind that none of the information provided here contains financial advice. I'm simply sharing my experience and knowledge, and it's given to you for educational purposes only. ICOs. Let's start by talking about ICOs, which is an initial coin offering. To understand it, think of all the companies that at the start of their journey didn't have enough money, so they would need to raise funds, find investors, or offer a part of their company's shares to the public. This sale of the company's shares is what's called an initial public offering. With crypto, a similar idea was proposed. Initially, projects would sell a part of their token supply to the public, which is what ICO is. Responsible for this process is the one and only team behind the project. This team also reaches out to exchanges, asking them for the listing of their token. Since listing takes time, the investors have to wait until it actually happens. The team behind the project is also responsible for managing their smart contracts. They are also responsible for promotion and advertising of their token. This sounds like a lot for often small teams or even individuals who want to do ICOs. This in turn leads to failure with many projects. Also, it leaves loopholes for those who want to exploit the system, scammers and other bad actors. Why? Because literally anyone can issue an ICO and the project themselves are not vetted at all. In fact, this rise in scamming activities led to ICO actually losing its popularity. As it happened, a new way emerged. IEOs. IEOs, or an initial exchange offering, was seen as a new and safer way to raise funds. This promise of safety came with the promise that the token would be listed on a centralized exchange and a part of supply would be sold through it. This way, the team behind the project isn't responsible for fundraising. The centralized exchange is. And since the centralized exchange is involved, there is no need to search for any exchanges and ask them to list your token. Smart contracts are also managed by the exchange, just as promotion and advertising. However, just as with ICOs, tokens are not immediately available for trading. Where IEOs really prove to be safer than ICOs, though, is a vetting process, which projects must go through before they will be listed. The requirements are quite high, which immediately eliminates a lot of those who wish to scam others. IDOs. The safety that IEOs provided felt nice for a while, but one of the main appeals of crypto in general is its decentralized nature. So obviously, when DEX or decentralized exchanges appeared, they instantly seemed like a promising option for fundraising. So with IDOs, a part of the token supply is sold through a decentralized exchange. They are the ones responsible for raising funds. When it comes to management of smart contracts and advertising, both DEX and the project issuer are responsible. This creates a nice balance because DEX might offer a bigger platform and a bigger reach on social media, but those efforts from the creators themselves can't be discounted. On DEX, there is no waiting period when it comes to tokens availability for trading. And finally, just like with trading on centralized exchanges, all projects must meet DEX's criteria and requirements. Currently, IDOs is one of the most popular methods of raising funds, as there are even special IDOs launch pads, which work with new projects. So to sum it up, ICOs were conducted on the exchanges that would agree to list your token. The lack of any screening was an important safety issue. With IEOs, listing is conducted on a centralized exchange. However, this centralization, while provides a set of requirements a project must meet in order to be listed, does create its own set of concerns. For example, cyber attacks. IDOs are done on decentralized exchanges, Because of it, there are almost no listing fees. The decentralized nature also provides more safety when it comes to cyber risks. It also means that not one single entity actually makes a decision of whether to list a token or not. Once the listing is done, the token might be traded immediately. However, all the good things that allowed for IDOs to become more popular option than ICOs and IEOs, and for which IDOs were praised, did create their own challenges and risks. All of them are associated with the fact that tokens can be traded as soon as the listing is done. Because the process is so fast, once the token is listed, the trading starts, and so the prices starts to change. Only a handful of people actually manage to buy it for the price listed. Then the price depends on what's going on the market. However, not always the new prices are determined by the natural market forces. Sometimes they are the result of pump and dump schemes. I've talked about pump and dump before on this channel. But if you are unsure about the term, a pump and dump is a scheme in which people inflate the price artificially by buying shares. Then once the price is high, they would sell their shares. In IDOs, scammers would buy a large numbers of a token that had just started to trade. This will increase the price, and then they would sell their tokens, driving the price down. So neither price instability nor these scams sound appealing. However, overall, IDOs are still a better option due to their advantages. How to launch an IDO? So by now, you might already know which route you would like to take with your coin. If you choose an IDO, a good point to start is to make sure that your idea actually makes sense. Think everything through. Once it's done, start writing your white paper. Again, I have discussed on this channel how important a white paper is when it comes to attracting investors. Don't try to sell and don't see your white paper as advertising. Your aim is to persuade and explain all the data relevant to your project. The next step is to actually create your coin. I made a separate video about it, which I will link in the description box below. Then you should make sure that you meet the requirements of the launchpad. Once you do, you can start with fundraising. This was our video for today. If you found it useful, consider subscribing. I'm Vlad, and this is your BunnyMoney channel. See you in the next episode.